Thank you, sir.
Shrimati Supriya Sule.
That two most important people who are required in this debate are here, the Honorable Environment Minister and the Honorable Health Minister. Because I think today's entire debate also connects both of them deeply, and actually the Health Minister has substantially contributed because a lot of data has been sent. I'll not get into this, but he and me have worked closely together. It's been a gliding light for us for tobacco control. And today's data says that the air pollution today kills a lot more in tobacco control. So I would urge him to take up this cause, because when it was about tobacco control and polio, Dr. Harshvardhan has really made a huge substantial contribution over last 3 or 4 decades, I think. And it's very, very important today to have this debate, because I would like to even highlight to Prakash Javadekar ji that the district that both of us come from, and Meenakshi Lekhi ji was talking about Delhi at length, the state that I come from, Pune district and Maharashtra. You'll be surprised to know that Prakash ji and me both come from that area. It's an area called Hinjewadi, which is the largest infotech park, with the name of Rajiv Gandhi Infotech Park. Today, the pollution, I just checked the pollution rate today, it is 427, which is severe. There is nothing burning there. There is a lot of traffic, but there's nothing burning there. There is no factory anywhere around there. But still, it is absolutely in the severe pollution range. So I think we really need to put our minds that it's not just one thing in isolation which is deteriorating the entire air pollution here. Since Dr. Harshvardhan ji is there, I would like to bring to his notice that the health report of 2015 said that the Air Act of 1986 needs to be integrated in our health policy. So when you're expanding such a big health policy, if we can integrate this, I think it will really make a big change. We can put all our minds together, give you a lot of recommendation. But I think this Air Act has to be integrated with health, because a lot of countries like Brazil, New Zealand, Canada and Philippines, I mean, they are doing much better with us with health and in pollution, and they have an integrated plan. I would also like to highlight a point which Ritesh Pandeji made. He talked about a state action plan for the country for pollution. As a matter of fact, we've just finished our Maharashtra election, and in our manifesto, this is probably the first time in a manifesto, which is of the Congress and the NCP, we have given 3 full pages to climate change. And in that, we have an entire plan for the state action plan, which is ready. It is in the manifesto. If anybody would like to visit it, I'd be happy. And if you need any more information, I'd be happy to share it with
everyone.
There are 2-3 quick points and questions. I won't repeat any points that anybody has made earlier. I would just like to ask the Honorable Minister that what is the status of the CAMPA fund? Because about 30,000 crores were given to states for plantations. In our own state, the government, which is incumbent right now, has told us that they have put in millions of trees. I don't see them, because in my own constituency, I won't talk about the state, but in my own constituency, I don't see a big change. So how is the government of India monitoring this exceptional amount of money? It's over 30,000 crores in the CAMPA fund going to all states. Who is spending it? How are they spending it? And if so much money is going into the environment and the CAMPA fund, then how are we not seeing any change and the results? And this is not about you versus us. I think this is a subject that we all need to put our minds to it, whichever government it is. Another 2 quick points is renewable energy everybody talks about. But the point is that with so much intervention in the renewable energy, how come we are not seeing a big change? Is there a problem with the kitty? Have we ever done a study? Because there are a lot of conferences for environment, a lot of signatures happened. Even in the Paris Convention, we've seen the big boys have all left it. We are the only countries which are the developing countries who have left it. So what will be our stand? A lot of people talked about Bharat Stage 6. Now, Bharat Stage 6, Parvesh Verma said that people from Delhi go next door to fill their gasoline because it's cheaper. And Delhi is Bharat Stage 6. Now, the point is, it's the comment of this government. By April, entire India is going to be Bharat Stage 6. So I'd like the Honorable Minister to confirm this to us, that we are going to be at BS6 by the time we get there. The other 2 last points is that the budget estimate in pollution control, there's a commitment in the last 6 months, how much of the budget estimate has been put into pollution control? I don't see that happening in my state. And there are so many reports that in 19, In 2000, there was a Shah report. In 2002, there was a Mr. Reddy report. In 2004, there was Mr. Gurjar report. And 2006, there was Mr. Garg's report. These are all reports on air pollution and pollution, and we're still all discussing these debates, and I really don't see we further deteriorated. So I think we really need to introspect that enough dialogue has happened, a lot of debates have happened, but no change has happened in this entire situation. I won't repeat the points of lawyers, but I would definitely like to make one point to Meenakshi Lekhi ji. She talked about several chief ministers, especially her, since she lives here more than I do, that they are spending a lot of money in advertising. I think he probably learnt it from us, because he became a chief minister earlier, and he has spent double the amount. So why don't we all put our minds together to it?
Area is far greater than the area of Delhi. So if you count the population and the geography, the records, no one can break Delhi's record.
Anyway, I am of the belief that governments are not commodities. They don't need to waste money on advertising. Instead of spending, they don't need to market themselves. In Marathi, we say, my bap sarkar. I mean, sarkar is your my bap. They have to do everything. They don't need to. They are not a soap that they need to advertise. So if they put all this money into pollution, why don't we all send a note in one mind to all the governments that instead of wasting money on advertising, why not all central and state governments put this money for all the social sector numbers, because social sector numbers in India are not doing, health is not doing well, and we do need more money for all this. So instead of wasting money on doing full page ads to newspapers, who won't like me saying this, but I think if we put all this money in social sectors and especially healthcare, I think it would be a great contribution on behalf. I thank Prakash ji, and I'm very hopeful. He's a very learned man, he doesn't need too many solutions, but in his reply, if you could kindly clear my point of all the reports and of the CAMPA fund, because that's my most concern in this. Thank you. Very good.